Welcome back, guys. Now in this lecture we will going to study the loopback interfaces. So what are exactly loopback interface, what is their purpose and how they are used? We will going to understand all these concepts regarding loopback interfaces. So one obvious question that naturally arises in our mind is that when we send a packet destined to a remote machine, what is the IP address we should specify as a source and destination IP address in the packet? Let us say, for example, machine A wants to send a packet which is destined to machine B. Then what should be the source IP address and destination IP address machine A should specify in the packet? So if A wants to send a data to the machine B, what should be the source IP address to be specified in the IP header of the packet? Now you can see that the machine A has two interfaces. Let's call it as interface 1 and the interface 2. Now interface has an IP address 10.18.1.2 and interface 2 has an IP address 11.18.5.1. So when machine A generates any packet destined to some remote machine in the network, what should be the source IP address machine A should specify? Should this be the IP address of interface 1 or should be the IP address of interface 2? Similarly, the next question that arises is regarding destination IP address. If machine A wants to send a packet to the destination machine B, then what should be the destination IP address machine A should specify? Should it be the IP address 192.168.1.2, that is IP address of interface 1 for machine B, or should machine A specify the IP address of interface 2 of machine B, that is 192.168.5.1? So what should be the destination IP address machine A should specify? So the question stands tall regarding when machine A wants to send a packet to the machine B, what should be the source IP address and what should be the destination IP address to be specified in the packet? So the answer is, A can specify the source IP address as IP address of any local interface. So machine A can specify the source IP address as IP address of any of its local interface. That is, machine A can specify the IP address of interface 1 or IP address of interface 2. Both will going to work. Similarly, machine A can specify the destination IP address as IP address of any local interface of machine B. Right? Thus, any combination of source IP, that is, source IP could be 10.18.1.2 or 11.18.5.1, and destination IP address could be 192.168.1.2 or 192.168.5.1. So as long as machine A specify any combination of these source IP and destination IP address in the packet will be eventually routed successfully by the network and the packet will reach the destination node B. That is, the packet would be delivered to the destination node B by the network layer. So in short, any combination of source IP address and destination IP address would result in the same fate of the packet. So actually, there is a need to come up with one deterministic way to specify the source IP address and destination IP address in the packet. So there is a need of deterministic way, right? At this point of time, it seems that machine A has too many options to specify source IP address and destination IP address in the packet, right? Though this will work, but in networking, there should be a deterministic way or there should be a rule using which the machines should specify a particular source IP address and destination IP address in the packet. So we will discuss what is that deterministic way. So guys, let us try to discuss the possible solution of the problem that we have just discussed. So there is a need to come up with special IP addresses which identify the L3 router as a device in the network, and that address should be unique. So loopback addresses help achieve this goal. So loopback addresses are used to represent the identity of a networking device. So you can see in the below diagram, the machine A has two interfaces with IP address 10.18.1.2. Let's call this interface as interface 1, and let's call another interface of the machine A as interface 2. Similarly, machine B also has two interfaces. Let's call it as interface 3 and interface 4, which have their own IP address configured on them. So you can see that machine A is configured with the loopback address 122.1.1.1/32, and machine B is configured with the loopback address 122.1.1.2/32. So loopback addresses are not tied to any physical interface of a machine, but actually they represent the identity of the machine itself. So if somebody asks you that, hey, what is the IP address of the machine A, then you should say that IP address of the machine A is 122.1.1.1/32. And if somebody asks you that what is the identity of the machine B, then you should say that the loopback address of the machine B is 122.1.1.2/32. So loopback addresses identifies the networking device as a whole in the network, right? So loopback addresses are used to represent the identity of the networking device. Now, if machine A wants to send a data which is destined to the machine B, then it is actually a good practice that machine A should specify the source IP address as its own loopback address, and it should specify the destination IP address as the loopback address of the destination machine. So this is actually a good networking practice. However, as I mentioned, that if machine A specifies the source IP address as IP address of any of its local interface and specifies destination IP address as IP address of any local interface of destination machine, the packet would still route it in the same way and will eventually reach the destination machine B. So specifying the source and destination IP address as loopback addresses is actually a good networking practice in the scenario when the machine A wants to send a packet to some specific machine B in the network. Now let us try to understand some of the properties of loopback addresses.